For we, the Knights of Britonia, will be your shield.
Okay, welcome back to Total War Warhammer, and problems are bound in the realm of Britonia. So in the previous episode, we united most of Britonia. I say most because we are missing this one little bit here. Oh, I guess we can check.
Welcome to fair Britonia.
Still is not wanting to join up with all his friendos, but there is that one little bit left. And we got a bunch of armies, a bunch of new cities, and a bunch of problems. Red Horns decided to clear war on us. Well, actually, they declared war on the Empire, and we sided with the Empire. Made peace with Middenland and Ostland, which I think is up there. Also, apparently, I forget that we were at war with them, but we were, and we made peace with them. So now it's time to kind of try and fix our economy, because right now we've got a whole lot of nothing going on. We've got a bunch of money to work with, so we're gonna work with it. I wanna build up these cities that are burnt down first. So were those the only two? I thought we had more. Oh, it's just that one. This one, Brion. Alright. Tower of the Enchantress. Yes. Yes, please. That's a special building. Build a weaving house. I think we'll wait on that one because it's probably going to be expensive. Oh, you've got our armory once. What would be good? What's this? Master Swordsmith. Perfect. Can't build that yet. Oh, we're saving that slot. That's right. We can get a better infantry. Or a better... That's going to get us a little bit of money, which we need. Is this growth? Alright, this is our rebellion province. That's right. Might be a good idea to I think we'll wait on that. I'm not sure what I wanna do. This one's got a lot of open slots, weaving house. Then stonecutter. Another weaving house. Alright.
King Louis Leoncoeur.
So since we don't need him up here anymore, and I don't want to piss off Middenheim too much, we're gonna go this way across.
Making my way.
As to try to not piss off as many people as possible. Alright, slowly work our way over. We do have the problem with these guys. And I've never fought against the Beastmen as the Bretonians yet. So I'm not sure exactly how that's gonna work with them. I do want to kind
of
bring all of my troops together a little bit, and I actually want to give Fae Enchantress this thing.
Moving out.
There we go.
My strength and wisdom are yours.
Who wishes the Grail?
Okay, you're level 6. Oh, you got all the vows. Okay, that's good. I didn't want that, but I mean, at least it was just one wasted skill point. It wasn't a bunch of them. Alright, so rank 9, we're able to get that. The chalice. we miss anyone? This dude. Oh, he's down there. I don't really want to push him out because he will get slotted. So we'll put him in here. You, yeah, you're right there. It's fine. Actually, no, I want you to give all of your stuff to the enchantress. There we go. That way, she's at least got a decent army. Alright, that's, I think, gonna be it for this turn. Losing a bit of money, but hopefully in a couple turns with all the stuff we've been updating, we will be making a good amount of money back. Damn it. That's already inactive. Alright. Well, that's fine. Yeah, I want to kill these guys off before they become too much of a problem. So I think that I'm going to bring my armies down here. And then these armies right here are going to be the ones that really assault. So I kind of switch places. Because if I assault with these guys, then these guys are going to take twice as long to get down. This way it's all going to be kind of at the same time.
We have met before.
So yeah, that's kind of a refresher on what's going on. I'm going to end this part right here. I'm going to start to move my armies around, and once something interesting happens this time, I should get it before I actually hit auto resolve. I'll try and remember. So I'll be right back. Alrighty guys, here we are in Bilbai. It's in the southern tip of our realm. The Red Horns have decided this is where they're going to strike first. You can't see it, but right up here I've got armies. They're about a turn and a half out. So unfortunately this could be a sacrifice city, but I want to injure these guys as much as possible, because first of all, these guys are completely expendable. I don't need them. But also because I know for a fact that I will get here before most of these guys resupply themselves or whatever, respawn. So if I can, especially if I can take out a unit or two, that'd be awesome. So these guys have got some special abilities, specifically these infantry, and they are anti-large. These minotaurs will have a hard time. So I'm feeling pretty good about this. We're not going to have a whole lot of cavalry or anything like that, but I think we can, we probably won't win this, I'm going to tell you right now. There's a very low chance we're going to win this, but I think if I can take out a unit or two, and if I can at least injure most of them, I think that I'll call that a good day if that's what happens. I think that these spearmen have a unbreakable stance where they fight to the last man, which is gonna be really useful, and I'll be able to use that to my advantage. Yeah, I just paid what, two or three turns ago to have this city raised from the dead, and it had been raised when Carcassonne owned it by these guys. So now it's going to get raised again, unfortunately, but that's okay. I'm not too upset about it. I think in the long run, the Empire is going to have to deal with their own. The Red Horn tribe, these guys are up in the Empire right now, wreaking havoc in Reikland, and, well, if we can take out the Bretonian side of things, I think we won't have to worry too much about them for a while. The Empire will have their hands full with them, but we won't. Alright, so first things first, do we have any kind of terrain advantages? Weird, because this camera, like, if I go kind of slow, it's slow, but then if I go fast, it just does a 360. If we were on this side, we'd have an awesome little bit, but I don't think they've got any kind of cavalry, so going in the trees isn't overly helpful. We might use this, because I think that, let's see, oh, you can go inside of there. I might use this to our advantage. And try and set up our units. I want you to look that way. Can we go in here by looking that way? Alright, let's see. Phalanx, Shield of Humanity. Charge defense. I swear one of these had a unbreakable. Last stand. Oh, I have to have less than 50% hit points. Okay. So as these guys start out pretty low already. Fortunately, I don't think I'm gonna be able to take great advantage of this little bit. But we'll be able to take a little bit of advantage. I think what I'm gonna do have these bows, because they're actually not bad. I kind of like them. And then if I orient these guys so that this is less than ideal to be. More than honest, it's not even close to ideal, but oh, that was not the one I wanted to change. I wanted to these are the ones I wanted to add. Do you have diamond? I'm not really sure that cavalry is going to be super useful, but I guess we can try and hide them in the trees. And who knows, we might be able to hit them in the back once they get in there. Or maybe even kill out their warhounds. I'm not sure that this is gonna fit back here, yeah. That's unfortunate, but they're expendable. I think I'll make them do their thing. Maybe even I'll put these guys up in the trees. They'll be hidden, hopefully, until the last second, and I'll come out and shoot him in the back. I like that. That's a good idea. Alright. I'm not sure if it's gonna work, but we can try it. So I wanna hit this one. So it will make us unbreakable. Oh, hit play. I must not have hit fast enough because oh, it's not making us unbreakable, I guess. We're not even gonna survive long enough for that. Oh good. Yeah, we didn't even survive a fucking charge. That's useless. Alright, well, I mean, if they're not even gonna survive a charge, they're anti-large, that's... There's really nothing you can do with that. Useless.
I mean, what are you gonna do? Oh,
it's fine. Bit disappointing. Kind of hope that the higher tier armies have got at least some of the units that don't have this shitty leadership failure that the peasants have here. I mean, the real reason that you can make the peasants really good is if you have the their leader near them. Having troubles earlier in the campaign, I was trusting that these guys would do okay on their own, and they really don't. I mean, these spearmen and swordsmen are a little bit better than the actual peasant mob, but the peasant mob, it's useless. Like it won't stand up to anything. It just routs way too easily, and not good. It's fine. Unfortunately, I don't think we'll be able to pick up that last province of Betonia until Chaos comes, because they're kind of isolated from everyone else because of us. We surround them, they've got mountains on one side, us on the other, and I mean, unless they do something really silly and go out and attack someone, I don't think that we'll ever have a problem. They will ever have a problem with that. I mean, because the reason that we got Kirkasone was because I believe the these guys we just lost to were raising all their settlements to the south, and then the Wood Elves declared war on them, and that tipped scales, and basically they wanted us. Yeah, so they're gonna raise it, YOLO. The nice thing is that if they try and come down here, I have a general here, so they can't actually raise this one yet. It looks like we're getting a little bit more money now, even though we lost that city. Now we are, yeah, we're two turns out, so I don't want to, if I go in a forced march, they can attack us and we'll be tired, but if I don't, still be close enough. I think we're close enough to them. My reputation precedes me.
Sallying forth. Absolutely not.
I want to be kind of in the middle. So this guy's going to be in forced march. The other ones won't be. So as you can see, we're two turns out for that. Might send this girl first, in case we spotted someone on the way.
The lion.
King Louis. This dude, we're just gonna have enter Paravon for now.
Honor me.
That way they think twice about actually attacking him.
I know the way.
Yes.
I think I'm gonna have him he'll stay right here for now. I don't want to play too aggressive just yet. I mean, it's not necessary. Alright. So yeah, these guys, next turn should be able to handle that. One turn away from that.
Welcome, friends.
Artois, I'm pretty sure that they were the first one that we had a chance to actually confederate with. Now.
The lady grants you safe passage in these lands.
Yeah, they've got a good economy, so we're not able to really give them gifts. And I'm not going to spend $2,000 every single time we want to give them gifts. That's more than we make in a turn, so it's not really worth it. Doing pretty good on the road to chivalry. Leadership plus 4. And another unit. Alright. So next turn we should be able to attack the Red Horns.
You are a guest in my realm. You will.
We want non-aggression. Well, see, the problem is that the Empire is going to be declaring war on you, or you're going to declare war on the Empire, and I'm trying to keep this reliability ranking up, so I can't keep breaking this non-aggression pact. I'm sorry, Boris, but I just can't do it. Oh, it's not something we need to worry about.
You seek the lady's favor.
For those that don't know, a Wa basically gives a green skin army, so the orcs, a second army that just follows them around. So for the price
of the realm.
And that second army you don't have to pay for, so it's just a free army that you can use to assault, or you can send it off on missions to do things. It's about the only good thing I like about the green skin, is getting those Wa's. So Albrecht.
My strength and wisdom are yours. Protector of the realm. Blessings of the lady be upon you.
Who calls me Hex? I tread softly.
I want you to get out of your forced march.
Lord and hero. Taking my leave.
Alright.
Blight my soul. Glory awaits.
Damn you.
He wills it. Going forth.
Who wishes the grail?
Guardian. Leaving.
You seek the lady?
I think he's gonna head up here. Fortunately, we lost. I dislike that they get the little extra bit whenever. It's frustrating. I'm trying to put a pin on people and about running away until I get lucky.
I served her late. I have seen the way.
Alright, we don't have enough money to really build anything after that, so try diplomacy, I guess. Of course, nothing has changed. And the turn.
As expected, France only comes calling when he needs something, but it's far too late.
Military access. Why would you need military access to our lands? No, I don't.
You are a guest in my
what do you want? Non-aggression. Same thing. You're dead. On breaking your treaty with the Empire. I'm gonna choose the Empire every single time. Oh, nice. Oh, you fucking kidding me? Well, you know what? If he's right here, he wasted movement points on this. I don't mind losing him. He doesn't have anything really that I can I care about, and it's not like I needed him. I mean, I've got so many armies right now, I can't even pay to have them filled out. Although that's not good. He had the blessing of the lady. Well, we're gonna fight. I'm not sure how well this is gonna go. I mean, probably just gonna get wrecked. fucking Christ. Everything I ever wanted and more. Thank you. One girl, Stoneheart, you're the best. Damn loading screens. It's kind of unfortunate because he was a level 6, but. Well. Would be really nice if I can. If I lose him and I don't end up killing these guys next turn, that's gonna make me angry. Because these guys used movement points to attack me. On top of. They're probably going to run away, and my bet is that they're going to go on a forced march to run away. I would... If... Oh my god, I'm going to be so pissed. Fuck it. If I wait all this time just to get wrecked, then to not actually kill this guy later on. What am I looking at? Oh. Why would you go through this little bit? Yeah, he doesn't have anything. But the best we can do is charge. Now luckily these guys are anti-infantry. Oh no, they're armor-piercing. Never mind, I thought they were anti-infantry. Having fun yet? know, if they decide to shoot arrows and kill their own guys, I'm okay with that. Now, actually, if he survives, that won't be a bad deal. He might be wounded or something, but I'm not sure if they're gonna let him survive. He's not an AI unit, so he doesn't get that weird bonus of, oh, well, you didn't completely kill him on the battlefield, so even though you killed everyone else in his army, the Lord, for some reason, is special and he gets to survive. I'm not sure if that works for us mere mortals. It only works for the AI. We'll see. We'll see pretty soon. Oh. Sitting here waiting. Like always. We really didn't do much to him. This worries me for when we actually have to fight these guys. Is if they're doing really, really well at killing my leadership, my morale, is that going to be a problem in the battle? Very well could be. Interesting. Oh wow, they're gonna let him survive. He might actually lose the blessing of the lady, but it does also look like we're gonna be able to take. Oh wow, perfect. Let's see, did he lose the blessing of the lady?
Do you know who I am?
No, he didn't. Awesome. So we can lose, we just can't retreat.
I protect Bretonnia.
You've also got the blessing of Lady. Alright. So, I want to Bane Chantress. Why did no one else come with her? Okay.
Call the lady.
I don't know why no one else
who
came with her.
Me hence?
But,
the land.
Very well, I go. Leaving. Guardian! I must keep my holy vow. No! Moving out. Lord. Going forth.
I want you to join in, or not. Apparently he's just not gonna join in. Alright. decisive victory. Perfect. We didn't even lose anyone, really. It's always good. Fuck these guys.
Moving out.
I think he died. Because I don't see him anywhere. He must have got sent back. I mean, gained battle reports. Okay. Oh.
Protector of
it's
the
fine.
Realm.
We'll go head over to,
victory.
Belby, and you can reclaim it.
Lord of Bretonnia.
We're gonna start moving everyone else up.
Who calls?
Alright, but here I want to
a good plan.
Get ready for this. I'm a
lady wears it.
I see much. Tis an honor. I know the way.
Yes. Attack! For the lady!
Devotee of the lady. I see my path.
Alright, that's everybody over there.
What is your behest?
The Enchantress, yes. I want you to start to move. Y'all up here as well.
You dare to ask this of me?
So, Albrecht, I want to give you a horse. Oh, you're not even Albrecht here, someone else.
Who wishes the grail? Morgiana.
Alright, you already have a horse. Lance of Bretonnia, charge bonus, missile resistance. What is this one? Blessing of the Lady. Oh, extra physical resistance. Is that for the entire army? Or just for themselves? Okay. So, I want the Inspiring Presence. We'll try and get the Lowborn Militia. It's got a couple of wasted points, but that's okay. Don't have a whole lot of money to spend, and it looks like we can't use it. Alright. So we'll assault them. We're at war with Crooked Moon. Them Red Horns, okay.
Welcome to Fair Bretonnia. Now is the time.
Anyone else we can trade with? Hell of a clan.
Greetings, lords. I hope the lakes of Bretonnia. Deliver your message. Greetings. We may not.
I suspect that they will be our conquest here soon as them. I still have to figure out whether or not we can take the Border Prince's lands or not, but, they may be a conquest as well. Alright. Next turn. And then I think that I'm going to end this episode. Yeah, we'll end this episode here. And on the next turn, I will come back and I will fight this battle. So I will catch you guys later.